And Japan has abandoned a US missile defense system. The move has raised concerns about Tokyo's ability to defend against missile threats from North Korea. The hunt is now on for an alternative system. Michio Ishida explains.
Defense Minister Taro Kono explained at the Foreign Correspondents Club in Japan, the cancellation of Aegis Ashore was due to its booster problem, which could not be controlled. One of the conditions to convince Akita and Yamaguchi prefectures to host Aegis Ashore was that the booster will not fall into their local communities. But this commitment could no longer be assured. So this cancellation was suddenly announced by Mr. Kono, and he was criticized by his party members for not consulting them on the decision beforehand. He said he didn't want the decision leaked to governors of host prefectures. Next, the National Security Council will look into other ways to defend Japan specifically from North Korea's threat. Mr. Kono said all options were on the table. He did not rule out developing preemptive strike capabilities. On North Korea, he suspected COVID-19 was spreading around the country, that North Korean leader Kim Jong-un was avoiding an infection, so that's why he is not making public appearances. Mr. Kono is suspicious of his health condition. He also thinks the economy is not doing good, with recent harvest poor. Now, he was unable to confirm any reference made on North Korean issues in former U.S. security advisor John Bolton's much-publicized book, stating he had not yet read it. Michio Ishida, CNA, Tokyo.